I'm waiting for viewers. No, I don't. I just remember he like tapped it too, that's all. Now we'll hack into your computer. Alright, so we will be replaying the last match because there was some. Ooh, team 3525. Robot seems to be on a rampage. But anyway, we will be replaying the end game of the last match because there was some disconnection that could have resulted in a change in the victor of the last match. So we will be replaying the end game of that. And we should be going on to our next match shortly. All right, team 3525 is starting on the left side for the Blue Alliance. E equals MC Squirreled is starting on the right side for the Blue Alliance. And team 7465 is starting on the left side for the right alliance. And their alliance partner is starting on the right side, team 4508. Let's see how this end game goes down. Alright, it seems that we need to reset Samantha so there can be Wi-Fi connection. Alright, so actually it seems that we will be replaying the entire last match. So the have been placed on the third peg. Let's see if these teams can score the autonomous block. Alright, so autonomous has begun and there is a competition for the platform. And it seems that both teams may have gotten on with E equals MC Squirreled and 93 both on the platform. So that's 20 points for each of their respective teams. Alright, so that signals the end of Autonomous. Now begins Teleop, where these drivers can control their robots. All right, so teleop has started with team 3525 going for the left blocks, trying to collect as many blocks as possible. Red team seems to both be on the reds on the left side, trying to contest blocks on that side. 3525 going for scoring on the leftmost bucket, where team 4508 on the right side for the Blue Alliance is collecting some blocks. Oh, so close for 3525. Let's see if they can get the blocks out. Yes, there we go. Four blocks for them. Great job, 3525. Now 4508 is going still for their blocks, whereas the Red Alliance seems to be some conflict in their pit area or their flag. Now 3525 seems to be stuck in their flag area, whereas E equals MC squirreled. Team 4508 is still moving over to the platform area. No, they are migrating to the left side, so then they do not contest their partner's blocks. Now 4508 is having some trouble with their movement, but team 3525 is going in for some more block scoring on the rightmost bucket. Let's see if they can score those four blocks. Oh, come on, 3525. Oh, 3525 has scored their blocks. Nicely done. But 7465 has scored a block in the rightmost bucket. Now that sound signals the end game, which is where you can score either hanging or the flag. Now 7465 has tried to gotten flag, but they do not seem to have sufficient connection. 64 to 93 is defending against 4508's hanging, but 3525 has scored some more blocks. Oh, 7465 is still trying to get the flag on the right. Oh, they have, oh, so close for 7465. Nice job by all the teams. Very good match, great scoring. Nice job by 3525 for their block scoring and balance. Great teamwork for the blue team, knowing to switch sides to control both pits and get as many blocks as possible. Nicely done.
Okay, I'm Nikhil. I'll be commenting for right now. So right now we just finished match number 7. So the next match will feature with Red 1, 5604, Red 2, 6493, and then the Blue Alliance is consisted of 4855 and 7013. This match was originally planned to have happened like 10 minutes ago, but they had to redo this match due to joystick failure, which we've been seeing in quite a bit of matches. So, now they're pulling the robots from the field and resetting it right now. Looks like we're about halfway through with the competition, so might be here for a little longer. We're on match number 8 right now. So now they're starting to put their robots on the field and up. So, again, 5604 is on the Red Alliance 1, 6493 is Red Alliance number 2, 4855 is Blue Alliance number 1, and 7013 with it's Blue Alliance number 2. So this will look like to be a very interesting match. So right now the first phase will be the autonomous phase, where you cannot joystick control the robot. So the point of this phase is to score the autonomous block into one of the goals determined by a dice rolling. And you can detect this randomly placed basket with an IR beacon, which will be underneath the basket. So most teams here feature an IO detection system, so we'll see if this is a high scoring autonomous. Another way to score an autonomous is parking, which is to park the robot on the ramp in the middle of the field. This gives the team or the alliance 20 points, and the autonomous block will score 40. The team scores that block in a non-IR basket, they will receive only 20 points instead of the full 40 points. Like, they're getting ready and are almost ready for the autonomous phase. So it looks like most of the robots are connected except for one by looking at the. I have to figure that out. All of these teams are very good teams, so it'll be a very high scoring match. Almost ready. Hopefully there won't be any failures or in this round, as many rounds have had either FCS problems or joysticks problems, or people have touched the robot, so we had to redo a lot of matches, and that's caused for a big delay. Hopefully that won't happen in this or future matches. Looks like it is being placed in the second IR, or third, I mean. Sorry, it's from the left. So, we'll see how that works. Okay, the match has started, and it looks like 7013 is going for an IR beacon, and 5604 is going for, both the red alliances have parked, and it looks like the Blue Alliance is... Wow, okay, sorry. So the Blue Alliance, Team 7013, has scored the autonomous block. 5604 and 6493 were attempted to park, but then Robot 7013 pushed them out of the way. So it looks like the Red Alliance has one robot on the ramp, and Blue Alliance has autonomous block as well as one parking. Like Team 4855 was attempting to score the IR, but somehow could not for some reason. Their arms seemed to get stuck. They seem like the gears are rattling on Team 4855's robot, so hopefully that won't be a problem. Right now it seems like the score is 60-20. In the favor of Blue Alliance. Now we're getting ready for the teleop phase, where the drivers can control the robots using joysticks. In this phase, the purpose is to score blocks on either corner of the field into either the baskets or the low scoring. Like, the match is... Drivers are grabbing the controllers, and we're ready for the teleop phase. Teleop phase is starting right now. See, Team 70-13 is going to one corner to collect blocks. Team 56-04 tried dispensing a block, lost one block. Now, Hotwire just scored, just collected blocks, and Team 56-04 just scored some blocks. Looks like 70-13 also has scored some blocks, and 56-04 has some blocks as well. 48-55 seems to be stuck, and or playing defense right now, and so, 56-04 is struggling to get out of the area in order to collect more blocks, and 70-13 has collected again some more blocks. While 56-04 has a very fast drive, allowing it to go between the collection and the dispensing very quickly. It's like a close match, and it might depend on the end game portions of the. Looks like 48-55 has a burnt motor, or because its drive is very slow. 70-13 is collecting more blocks. Just dispensed, and now it's collecting more blocks. Looks like it has emptied a lot of the dispension area. 70-13 is attempting to do hanging, and they've done fly. And balance. So 70-13 has successfully hanged, and 48-55 is trying to make its way to the flag. This seemed like a very high-scoring match with 50 points for hanging. Red Alliance has a balance. Seems like they both alliances scored many blocks. Red Alliance has a flag, but Blue Alliance got autonomous. So. See who won this match in the future, but it seems like a very close game.
Alright, that was a very close match. Seems that Team 4855's bucket may have had some issues when it made contact during autonomous. It seems that they were also moving slower than usual, so they were forced to play defense, unable to score blocks. So Team 70-13, however, did score a sufficient amount of blocks and did hang in the end, and did score their autonomous block in the beginning, as well as parking. So although Blue may not have been able to score as many blocks as they could have, their alliance seemed very their scoring seemed very high. Now for the Red Alliance, they had some very nice playing by 56-04 with their quick block scoring and quick flag raising. So great job to them, and as well as balancing. Also, Red Team played a very good defense against Team 4855, preventing them from getting to the flag, so that was great work by them. Great match overall, and great teamwork from both teams. Seems to be some dispute over whether 70-13 is hanging on their side of the platform. We'll see if the Blue Alliance does get the points for hanging. So they are taking a photo of the hanging robot 70-13 and will assess whether or not that has hung later. But now robots are being removed from the field and the next match is starting. Right, so they are readjusting the platform to make sure that it is aligned with the tape correctly. IR beacons are being reset, blocks are being put back, and robots are being taken off the field. Alright, seems like team 4855 may not have had such a fortunate match then, because their encoder wire was not in properly. So then their arm did not stop when it was needed to, so it caused a motor to burn out and zip ties to be broken. So hopefully that can be fixed by next match. However, now the field is being reset for the new teams. Team 6559 and team Afufa are on the Red Alliance for this game. Let's see, they are facing the Blue Alliance. And from this matchup, we can see that Team Afufa has scored quite a few autonomous blocks today. Let's see if they can score yet another block to give them a 40-point advantage at the very start of the match. Alright, robots are getting put on the field now. Let's see what their positioning strategy says about their whole gameplay for this 2.5 minutes. Alright, team 5939 is starting once again on the left side of the Red Alliance face. This will allow them to do their drive-by autonomous with their arm that flings out of the robot perpendicular to its front face, so then it may find the bucket once it has identified the IR beacon. For the blue team, team 5938 is lined up on the left side, facing once again the platform, possibly going for it or going for an advantage for block collection. Their alliance partner, team 7766, is on the opposite side of their triangle, allowing for them to also get a nice angle for the platform or also a nice position for block collecting. Overall, both teams' starting positions seem very good for either autonomous or block scoring. We'll have to see how this plays out and how the teams go about fighting for those blocks during scoring, balancing, and into the end game. Alright, blocks are being reset. Final changes are being made. Blocks for the autonomous period are being put into the robots. Alright, autonomous is about to start. Alright, so the teams are getting ready for autonomous. Alright, the IR beacons are going to be put down on the first peg. This will mean that it is very close to team 39's robot. Let's see if their arm can still score the autonomous block. Now, the Blue Alliance does not seem to be in position to score their autonomous block, but we will see. Oh, Blue Alliance going directly for the platform. Oh, but seems that their robots have collided, making it so that both get 10 points for the platform, but do not get the full 20. And it seems that Team 5939 has scored their autonomous block for 40 points. And it also seems that Team 5939's alliance partner has also gotten onto the ramp. Not all the way, so that will be 40. That will be another 10 points for the Red Alliance. No problem. So, during this autonomous, the Red Alliance has successfully gotten 50 points, one from their autonomous block, another from their Alliance partner team, 6559's parking. Now, for the Blue Alliance, 7766 and their Alliance partner have half parked, giving them a total of 20 points. Let's see if they can make up those 40 points. Let's go. Alright, so, the team 5939 is going directly for the rightmost blocks. Now their Alliance partner team 6559 is maneuvering around to the leftmost blocks. Now 5938 is trying to play some moderate defense, but 6559 is enlisting penalties by touching the blue balance beam. However, 5939 is going in for some collection with two blocks in their block collector. They are going in for the dump to see if they can get two blocks. 5938, however, is being compressed against a wall by the Red Alliance on the left side. Oh, 6559 is running into 5938. This may be a penalty. They may have lost control. We are not sure. Now 5939, however, is on the right side and is still collecting blocks. But the Alliance partner for the blue team has fallen over, so they will not be able to be of any use for this match. 5939, however, does have one block in their block collector and will try to score it. There we go. 5939 has scored another block. 5938 on the left side is still pinned against the wall, so they will not be able to move for this match. 5939 is just freely scoring blocks on the right side. Now, endgame has started. 5939 will stop collecting blocks and go directly for hanging with 50 points in the endgame. Now, let's see if 5939 can successfully hang. Their hooks have latched on, and they will begin to raise themselves for a successful hang. Nicely done by 5939. 3 seconds left in the match. And it seems that the red team has gotten more points than the blue team. The blue team did have one robot flip over and another robot pinned against the wall because of a technical failure on the red team's controllers. But team 5939 was still able to score blocks during that period, successfully hanging, balancing the balance beam, and getting their autonomous. Great job by red team, and great job by blue team. Alright, so the referees are tallying up their scores. Alright, so team 7013 and team 6493 will be up for the Red Alliance next match. They will be facing team 7465 and team 3525 for the Blue Alliance. Let's see how this goes down. Team 7013 has scored autonomous and gotten their robot onto the platform fairly consistently today during autonomous, meaning that they have gotten an additional 60 points quite often, giving them an advantage over other teams. Let's see how this plays out. Team 3525 for the Blue Alliance that will be coming up next match has also had fairly quick block scoring during today's tournament. They are able to pick up 3 to 4 blocks fairly consistently and at a rapid pace with their gate mechanism blocking their blocks from falling out. So versus a successful autonomous and consistent block scoring, there will be a very, very harsh competition for this match. Yes. All right.
Cecilia Young.
All right, so we would like to give a shout out to
parents in
Maryland.
Hey, Sid and Cecilia Young, thanks for watching the grandkids competing, and thanks to Batteries in Black for live streaming.
All right, so referees are making up the final tallies. And then the next match will be going underway. Alright, so final scores are being made. Teams are signing their scoring sheets that they are agreeing with how the match was played and scored. Robots should be off the field momentarily, and the next teams should be put on soon. Alright, for this match, there was no flag raising, mostly because Team 5939 made the decision to go for hanging over flag because of the high point value of hanging. Hanging is more difficult than most would believe to support the weight of your entire robot, not only to pull it up above the ground so there is no contact with the platform below it, but also, you must be able to hold your robot up, even when power is cut off. So nicely done to Team 5939 for doing so. Alright, so the next round will be starting momentarily with Team 7013 and Team 6493 for the Red Alliance. And Team 7495 for the Blue Alliance and 3525 as their alliance partner. So the blocks are being located to their respective pits, and the robots will be on the mat shortly. The IR beacons have been put up, flags are still down, robots are off the field. This match will begin momentarily. All right. So Team 7465 has been set up for the Blue Alliance, put on the red side, or the right side of the Blue Alliance space, pointed directly at the rightmost blocks. This will allow them a quick access to those blocks on the right side of the mat, so then they can score as many blocks as possible. Their alliance partner, Team 3525. Seems to be angling their robot towards the platform. This will give them a potential 20 points if they can get their robot all on the platform. However, today, we have seen some pushing on that platform, contesting for those 20 points. Whether it's alliances not quite communicating and then getting pushed off by each other, or the other team defending their control over the platform. It has been a contested location and a much desired 20 points by both sides. Alright, so team 7013 is getting their robot set up on the left side of the Red Alliance face. This will allow them to do their drive-by autonomous, which has been fairly successful today, and will allow them to drive around for the platform 20 points. Their robot is quite bulky with a mass that is quite high, which will allow them to have a large force when trying to push other robots off of the platform. Now let's see, this match will begin shortly. The red team has positioned their robots on both sides of their triangle. This will allow them to have maximum efficiency when scoring blocks and allows them to get to their blocks as quickly as possible. The team 7013's alliance partner seems to be facing towards the center platform, giving them a possible 20 points if they can park their robot successfully. However, their robot seems to not have many parts on their chassis, which will make their robot quite light and possibly not able to contest the center platform. But we shall see what happens during this showdown that is the 10th round of today's matchups. All right. So this round is about to go down with autonomous. Alright, so IR beacons have been placed on the third peg. This will be a short distance away from 7013, but I do not see that the Blue Alliance is in position to complete autonomous, but we shall see what happens. Alright, autonomous is beginning. Alright, team 3525 immediately goes for the platform, 20 points. And 7013 goes for autonomous block and successfully gets it. That is 40 points. Nicely done. 7013 is pivoting their wheels so then they can contest the platform. They may drive right into that robot, trying to push them off, but they both get on the platform. Nicely done by 3525 and 7013. Alright, so autonomous is over, and the Red Alliance has successfully scored their autonomous block. That is worth 40 points, and has successfully parked on the platform for another 20 points. So right now they are ahead by an autonomous block, or 40 points. So let's see if the blue team can make up for that deficit by some nice late game strategy and some efficient block scoring. Alright, controllers are being picked up, and teleop will begin shortly. There seems to be some controller confusion going on the Red Alliance side. Hopefully this could be sorted out. Alright, teleop is beginning now. Let's see how it goes. So blue team 3525 is immediately going for the rightmost blocks. 7013, however, is ramming into them, trying to contest it. Red Alliance 7013 is going for the rightmost blocks as well, trying to contest those blocks from blue team. Blue team has two robots going directly for the rightmost blocks, hopefully trying to get as many blocks as possible. However, this may be an issue when trying to balance. Red team's robot 6493 is not scoring as many. It's not getting blocks, but 7013 has scored 4 blocks. Nicely done on the outermost. That is 12 points. Now, 3525 is going for some more blocks, but seems that 7013 has gotten another 4 blocks, it seems, and is lifting them up yet again for some more points. Another 12 points, it seems. 3525, however, is making a fierce fight for it, putting in yet another 4 blocks, but 7013 is migrating to the left side, trying to go for that balance. They're ramming into the blocks, hopefully getting another 4 blocks. Yes, they have swept in another 4 blocks. Okay, let's see. Can they get those blocks in to balance it? Nicely done. Four more blocks. It is near balanced. 35-25, however, is still trying to get more blocks to get more points. They may be able to balance. We are not sure, though. There is only 10 more seconds until endgame. And 70-13 seems prepared to do their hanging. And 70-13 seems to be also trying to get more blocks. No, 70-13 is determined to get their hanging right. So they have hung their robot. But blue team has raised their flag up to the uppermost point, and 35-25 has scored more blocks. Not quite balancing. That may be balanced for the blue team, actually, but we are not quite sure. Nicely done by the red team, successfully hanging and getting their autonomous scored. This has been a very close match, and nicely done by both teams to get as many blocks as possible. Great teamwork by the blue team, positioning their robot to get the flag as well as allowing another robot to score blocks and try to balance. Red team, nicely done by team 70-13, going in for the balance and the hang, and a successful autonomous. Nicely done. So referees are seeing if hanging is allowed. They're getting signatures to make sure that the scoring was legal. It does not seem that the Reds' basket was balanced, however. So that may leave some opportunity for blue team if their basket was successfully balanced. Red team did score quite a few blocks. I see about 8 of them in the outermost baskets and 1 in the innermost. That should allow for them to get about 26 points. 26 points, which should give them a nice lead on the other team. But we shall see if blue team has done enough with their flag and attempts at balancing the balance beam to catch up to red team's score. Alright, so the next match is coming up. This match will include 59-38 and 65-59 for the red team. And for the blue alliance, there will be 55-08 and 56-04 for the blue alliance. All right, so the blocks are being put back, and the robots are being removed from the field, and the new robots are getting placed on the field. So E equals MC squirreled is now being placed on the right side of the field. One side of the field. Now E equals MC squirreled has been using a tread system for their block collection. This allows for them to have an efficient collection system from the ground up, which allows their tread system allows for them to collect the blocks on the ground, lift them up, and score them without need of much arm movement. Their partner team, 5604, has also had very efficient block scoring. Their system has used zip ties to rapidly collect blocks, consistently collecting 3 to 4 blocks, and they're elevating block collection system allows for them to score blocks efficiently by raising their arm. However, Team 59-38 and Team 65-59 are determined to give them a hard competition. They will attempt to get onto the platform and possibly score an autonomous block, making it harder for the blue team to secure a victory. Red team has good teamwork and will most likely put up a very hard fight for blue team. Let's see how this match goes down and what their match strategy is. Let's see what things they go for in the endgame, where the IR beacon is placed, and whether or not they will get their autonomous goals of platform and the basket scoring. Alright, referees are making final checks for if the blocks are in place. Alright, the IR beacon is being placed on the first slot, right side for the blue alliance and left side for the red alliance. Let's see how these teams do. Alright, the match is starting with autonomous. Alright, so there are two blue robots going for the platform. Oh. But team 6559 has tried to score their autonomous block, except it was so close to getting in to the second basket. Two blue robots have gotten onto the platform, but it seems that the rightmost blue robot may not have been fully on the platform, so that may only be 30 points for the blue team. Red team has gotten one robot, team 5938's robot, on the platform, giving them 10 points. Let's see how this goes down. Blue team is currently up 20 points, but a couple block scores could easily make that go in red's favor. From what we can see, team 6559 has a flag spinning mechanism on the rear end of their robot, so that will give them more potential points in the endgame. However, the blue alliance also does have that potential, so that may be a potential scoring for them as well. Alright, so teleop is beginning now. Let's see how this match goes down. Team 5938 is going for the red side, where both blue robots are located, trying to play defense against both of them. Now team 5604 is driving all the way around blue side, or red side, trying to get to their block scorers. Alright, so... 5535 is about, 5694 is about to flip over. Oh no, they are driving around for their scoring. Now 5938 is still trying to play defense against 4508, but 5604 has successfully scored two blocks. 6559, however, almost scored one block, but was very close, but missed the edge slightly. 5938 is now again trying to play defense against 6404 on the left side of the mat. 6404, however, has a very fast drivetrain and is still able to score three blocks on the left side, on the right side, and one block on the right side, making it so that they have a nice balance on their pendulum. 6559, however, has scored two blocks on the left side of the red pendulum and has put two blocks under the red pendulum, giving them additional points. 5938 is getting control of the middle platform, and that sound is the sound of the endgame. 5604 is still trying to score more blocks, but has launched a block out of the playing area. Their robot is now going for flag and is raising it at incredible speeds and has successfully raised it for the 35 points. Team 6555 is going for flag now and almost has a grip on it but cannot quite get it. Alright, so the 6559's flag is raising. Oh, and does not quite make it to the 25 point mark. So close by red team. Red team's pendulum is balanced, but blue team has scored quite a few blocks. Nicely done by Red Team. Great attempts at defense by Team 5939's robot for the Red Alliance. But nicely done by Team 5604 by their quick maneuvering and their fast block scoring. So great job by both teams. So now we are on match number 12 with Team 5939 on the Red Alliance, and their partner is 6559. On the Blue Alliance is Team number 4508, and their alliance partner is Team 5604. So this should be a good competition between two very good teams. Alright, so the Red Alliance's robots are being taken off, and the new competitors are coming on momentarily. The flag is being lowered. The field is being reset. And we should be beginning the match very soon. Alright, so the field is being reset, and the next match should be beginning within a minute or so. Thank you all for being here to listen to and watch this stream. We are currently in the Washington League tournament with 12 teams present. There has been much wonderful competition today, much great strategy, and much great robot performance. It has been wonderful watching these teams and streaming their great strategies and engineering results. So thank you to all of these teams that have made this possible, and great job to all of you. Now we will be moving on to our 12th round momentarily. Alright, so the robots are going to be placed on the field for the next match. Alright, Team 7766 is putting their robot on the right side and facing the middle platform so then they can drive on for those 20 points. Team 5939 is positioning their robot again for their drive by autonomous, trying to get those 40 points for scoring the autonomous block in the IR Seekers basket. Now the blue team has positioned their robots for one what appears to be an autonomous by Team 4855, and another robot, Team 3525, for the center platform. Let's see how this goes down. The autonomous blocks are being put into the respective baskets, and the robots are being set on their correct programs. Hopefully this will be a very interesting match, because Team 3545 has been scoring a high amount of blocks very consistently today. Now also, Team 4855 has had an autonomous that has worked sometimes and can park on the ramp. So that could give them a potential 60 points with Team 3585's ramp program as well. But team 5939 on the bottom left side for the Red Alliance has also scored their autonomous block fairly consistently. So we will have to see how this goes. All right, so actually team 3525 is subbing in for a team that has left today, but we will have to see how this match goes down. All right, so team 5939 has scored their autonomous block. Batteries in Black has scored their autonomous block nicely, but their arm seems to be caught on the balance beam. Oh, but 5855 has not successfully gotten onto the platform, but has scored their autonomous block. Nicely done. And team 3525 has gotten onto the platform for the Blue Alliance. So that is 60 points in total for the Blue Alliance. But the Red Alliance has scored their autonomous block, giving them 40 points. So we will have to see if the Red Alliance can make up those 20 points that the Blue Alliance has gotten. It seems that a balance beam may also be malfunctioning on the blue side. All right, now the balance beam is back in action. It was just stuck on the mats. Now teleop will be beginning soon. The Blue Lines has some nice scoring potential with some fast scoring from team 3525 as well as from 4855. Now let's see how this match goes. But team 7766 on the bottom right side for the Red Alliance does have a low center of gravity, but team 4939 has jammed the red balance beam into the ground. Team 3525 on the left side for the Blue Alliance is preparing to get some blocks, while team 4855 is playing defense against the Red Alliance's robot, team 5539. This will make team 5539 have to go completely around their robot to even potentially score, while 3525 is going to score. Let's see. Nicely done. Three blocks on the leftmost pendulum. Oh, and 5939 drops their three blocks on the ground. Now 4855 is following 5939 again on the left side, trying to prevent them from scoring any blocks, playing successful defense against 5939. While the Blue Alliance partner 3525 is trying to balance the blue pendulum and will try to score more blocks on the outermost basket. 5939 is being defended against yet again. But 7766 on the right side for the Red Alliance is maneuvering around the ball pit, the block pit there. 4855 seems to still be playing defense against 5939, making it so that they cannot get to their red pendulum. 4855 is now trying to get to the flag, so they can get another 35 points for their alliance. Now 3525 is trying to score some more blocks in the last minute for the Blue Alliance, but team 5939 is trying to raise the flag, but seems to be stuck against something. Oh, team 4855, can they get their grasp on the flag? Oh yes, they've gotten their flag. No, seems that team 4855 has not gotten enough traction on the flag, so they were so close to raising it to the first mark. But that was a nice match by both of them. Great teamwork by Blue Team and a great autonomous by the Red Team. Hopefully there are no penalties for team 4855 for those defensive maneuvers against team 5939. There's been some great teamwork by both teams, but I believe that the Blue Alliance gave us a very nice show of a defensive maneuver as well as an efficient scoring robot. Team 3525 took advantage of the fact that they could freely score blocks and scored as many blocks as possible, while Team 4855 defended against 5939's block scoring abilities and delayed them as much as possible so they could not get the blocks that they needed to make the comeback. Alright, so the robots are being picked up and a new team will be put in. Alright, so for the next match, there will be Team 3525 again for the Red Alliance. And their alliance partner will be Team 7013. Team 7013 has had a fairly consistent autonomous, being able to park on the platform as well as getting their autonomous block in. So this should be a very interesting match. But 7013 and 3525 will be facing Team 4508 as well as Team 5938. 4508 is E equals MC squirreled and they have a tread scoring mechanism. Although they have not been taking much advantage of it today, it has the ability to efficiently collect blocks, move them up their robot, and score them without need of much arm movement. Team 4508's alliance partner, Team 5938 on the Blue Alliance, also has a very nice robot. It has a large mass so then it is not easily pushed around and can also score blocks fairly well. Team 5938 are the loose screws high school and use a arm that will be able to lift blocks up from the ground and score them in the balancing baskets at any desired height. Now for the Red Alliance, they are positioning their robots, one on the left side, which is Team 7013's robot for the drive-by autonomous, and one on the right side, which is Team 3525's, which will drive onto the platform, as seen in the last match. Now, Team 5938 on the Blue Alliance side, on the left side, is now also positioned to drive onto the platform, which may contest 3525's robot. Now, Team 4508's robot is also positioned on the blue side towards the right to give them a positional advantage and possibly scoring an autonomous block by the looks of it. So there will be some autonomous block scoring and there will be some large contestation for the middle platform. Let's see how this goes down and see who will come up on top after the autonomous. Alright, so Team 7013 is preparing their robot, getting their program selected, making sure that everything is in order before the round starts. Alright, so it looks like the teams are about ready for action. Team 7013 looks like they are about ready, and their robot is about prepared for this next round. Alright, it seems the drivers are ready. The autonomous blocks are in position. The IR beacon is about to be placed, and by the looks of it, it is being placed on the second slot. Let's see if Team 4508 and 7013 will be able to score their autonomous blocks. Oh, and it seems that the blue side's flag may not have been lowered all of the way. So they are doing that now. Alright, so autonomous is beginning now. Alright, team 5538 is going onto the platform. Team 7013 has scored the autonomous block and is maneuvering. Oh no, has been blocked by their alliance partner. Oh no, the red alliance has not successfully gotten onto the platform. And it does not appear that the blue alliance has scored their autonomous block. So currently the blue alliance does have an advantage of 20 points over the red alliance because they did park their robot on the platform. Sadly, team 3525 of the red alliance did not run their program, so could not get on the platform and also block their alliance partner from doing the same. Actually, it seems that the red alliance is ahead by 20 points because they scored the autonomous block. So the score is currently 40-20 in the red alliance's favor, but the blue alliance could, with good teamwork and good block scoring as well as endgame strategy, turn this around. Ah. 5938 has successfully parked on the board. Alright, so Teleop is beginning now. 5938 is moving to the right side, trying to possibly play defense against team 3525. 7013 is trying to collect the blocks on the right side and has successfully gotten 4 blocks, it seems, and is about to score them. Yes, has scored 4 blocks. Now team 4508 is trying to get some blocks as well, and 5938 is trying to play defense, but because 3525 is also scoring on the left side, he cannot play defense against both of them. 7013 has just rammed their arm into team 5938's robot. 7013 has scored yet another 3 blocks. 4508 is still trying to collect some blocks on the right side, while 3525 for the red alliance on the right side has been calmly collecting blocks, trying to balance out 7013's returns on the right side. The red alliance has been trying to score a variety of blocks and has successfully scored many, but their balance beam is still yet to be balanced, but the blue team does not seem to be able to score blocks, and it seems that their robots have collided, and one robot has lost connection, and is spinning on the field. It seems that team 5538 has lost connection, but the red alliance has gotten their blocks in their respective baskets and has almost balanced their balance beam. 7013 seems to be ramming into team 5938's robot, which is... Oh, they have lost control. Oh, team 7013 as well as team 5938 have both lost control of their robots. Oh no, team 7030 has gotten their robot back. But it seems that the red team has scored many blocks, but has not balanced the balance beam. The pendulum is not balanced, but has many blocks scored, and I do not believe the blue team has scored any of their blocks. So this has been a valiant effort by the blue team to defend against the red team's scoring attempts and score their own blocks, but it looks like the red team has come out up on top during this round. Alright, so the referees are counting up final scores. And match 14 will be underway soon. So match 14 is underway. There will be 16 matches today. So we are almost done with this tournament. There have been a variety of robots here and a variety of scoring mechanisms. It has been an honor to see all of these scoring abilities and these robots here today. Now match 14 will be beginning soon. There will be robot... There will be team... There is team 74-65 as well as team 77-66 for the Red Alliance and team 65-59 and team 4-8-5-5 for the Blue Alliance. All right. So team 74-65 is being set up on the left side of the Red Alliance corner. They are positioning themselves for what appears to be an autonomous attempt. And team 77-66 is set up again on the right side of the field, positioning their robot so then they can drive on to the center platform. Now team 65-59 is going to be allied with team 4855, Batteries in Black. Batteries in Black have had their autonomous attempts today and may have it successful this time. They're currently testing to see if their flag mechanisms work, but we shall see what they do. Team 6559 seems to be ready to try to contest the platform from team 7766, but it also seems that 7465 is also at an interesting angle for an autonomous attempt. Typically today we have seen teams drive their robots parallel to the balance beam, but 7465 is positioned to drive into it, so they may try to turn or hope that it is on the first basket. Let's go see what they do and see how successful these teams are. Team 4855 is actually positioned at an angle towards the rightmost block area. All right, so robots are getting positioned. Team 6559 is being positioned on the left side of the field, right in front of their flag area. So then they seem to be wanting to not interrupt Team 4855's autonomous. I'm not quite sure what is going on, but we shall just have to see. This should be an interesting match between two great teams. So this match should be underway very soon. They're making some final adjustments. Alright, so autonomous is beginning now. Oh, it seems that team 7766 has overdriven the ramp, but has gotten 10 points for their autonomous. Team 4855 has not attempted their autonomous, so they have been safe to not damage their arm. Team 7766 is joyful that they got on the ramp. That is very good. Nicely done by them. All right, so autonomous is now over. Now will be the 2-minute teleop session. All right, so currently the red team has a 10-point advantage, but we'll see what can happen in this teleop round. All right, so team 4855 directly goes for the rightmost blocks. Team 7766 seems to be taking control of the center platform, but might be trying to play defense against team 4855. Team 7465 for the red team on the left side is driving back and forth, trying to push blocks into the bottom area, trying to get that 1 point. Team 4855 is trying to score blocks and has successfully scored 3 blocks in the rightmost area of the blue pendulum. Team 7766 is trying to block the left area of the platform, trying to make sure that Team 6559 does not get control of that. Team 4855, however, is on the right side and has complete control of that block area and is still trying to collect blocks there. They have gotten their share and are now trying to go for the balance of the pendulum. Now they are trying to place their blocks in the furthest left pendulum basket and have successfully done so. Now the pendulum should be balanced. Team 7766, however, is parking their robot. Oh, now it seems that Team 7766 has flipped over onto Team 4855's robot. This has not been seen before, but was a nice maneuver by Team 7766 to try to block Team 4855's attempt at the blocks. Now Team 7465 for the red team is now trying to flip the flag. Oh, but they are spinning it the wrong way. Oh, now they are spinning the flag up. Nicely done by the Red Alliance, getting those 35 points. Now Team 4855 is about to spin their flag up. Nicely done by them. 15 seconds left in the teleop. The red flag is completely extended. The blue flag is being raised and is also extended. Nicely done by both teams. There is a balanced pendulum for the Blue Alliance as well. Sadly, Team 7766 robot was flipped, but they had the right strategy in mind to block Team 4855's from trying to get the blocks. Nicely done by both teams. Great teamwork. Great match. Hopefully there is no penalty on Team 4855 for the flipping of Team 7766, as their arm was stuck under 7766. We will have to see what the referees think about it. Alright, so they're clearing the field. The judges are talking with the players to make sure that they agree with the scoring, and the robot should be off the field momentarily. And the next match, the 15th round of today, should be beginning shortly. Today there are actually 18 matches, so there will be 4 matches after today's. Alright, so it has been declared that there are no penalties against Team 4855. So that is good for them. Now the next match, there will be Team 5604 and 4145 for the Red Alliance. They will be facing the Team 6493 and 5939 in the Blue Alliance. All right. Thanks again for watching this live stream, and we are currently in a Washington League tournament. Today we have seen a variety of robots that have all performed extremely well, each with their own capabilities and scoring mechanisms. Our 15th match is about to start right now. It seems that the Red Alliance has team 35-25, which is known for their fast block scoring and autonomous ability to park on the platform. Team 56-04 has very quick block scoring and is able to park on the platform as well. So we'll have to see if they have some platform conflict and if they can live up to that fast block scoring that has won them so many matches today. Alright, so it seems that both teams may be almost ready for action. Alright, so the robots are in position. The red team's robots are split up on both sides of the field, so then they do not interrupt each other during their autonomous runs, and hopefully both can get on the platform. Blue team has done a similar thing with team 59-39's robot positioned for their drive-by autonomous, which can score one block, while their alliance partner, team 64-93, is positioned to drive and contest the center platform as well. We'll have to see how this goes down and who wins the platform in the end, and if the blue team can successfully get their autonomous block scored. The round is about to start. The IR beacons have been decided to be placed on the fourth peg, which is far away from team 5939, who is attempting to do the autonomous run, but can still be done by them. Now let's see how this goes down. All right. Oh, team 59-39 has not gotten their autonomous scored, whereas team 56-04 and 52, team 35-25 have gotten both their robots onto the platform. So the red team currently has a 40-point advantage against the blue team. Hopefully the blue team can make this up with some nice endgame strategy and some quick block collecting. Alright, so tele-op has begun with 35-25 going for the rightmost blocks. Oh, and team 56-04 has already tried to score. Oh, no, they have missed their leftmost bucket. Oh, they are trying to adjust their collection and are about to dump while 35-25 has successfully scored their blocks. Oh, and team 5904 has successfully scored their two blocks. Team 5939 is trying to go for their first score on the rightmost of the blue pendulum. Team 5604 is now going with their four blocks on the leftmost pendulum area. Nicely done by them. Team 3525 has scored another four blocks on the rightmost pendulum area as well. Team 5939 has scored one block on their rightmost blue pendulum. Team 64-94 is still trying to drag some blocks into the bottommost area of their blue pendulum, but are having success. Team 5604 and team 3525 have scored even more blocks on their respective pendulums. 6504 is still trying to pick up blocks, but has gotten one block and is now about to score it. Team 3525 has already scored many blocks on their side. I believe, scored about 9 to 10 blocks. And that sound means that it is the end game, meaning that red team will want to try to get their flag. Now 5604 is going for the flag. Oh yes, and they have raised their flag to the full extent. Nicely done by team 5604. While team 3525 is trying to balance the pendulum. And 5939 is trying to hang, but cannot successfully hang. Oh, seems that 5939 may have lost power, but they do not have a successful hanging robot. Alright, so teams seems that the red team has successfully balanced the pendulum and have scored about 15 to 18 blocks by the looks of it. And they have raised the flag to their full extent and scored, and have gotten two robots onto the middle platform. So, great teamwork by the red team to have the pendulum balanced with two exceptionally good scoring robots, and nice try to the blue team with their hanging attempt and their autonomous attempt.
Hello guys, I'll be substituting for commenter for the next match. Yeah. The next match will be 7766 and 4855 versus 3525 and 5938. Very intense match, just like the previous one that we just had. Coming to a close with this competition with only three more matches, but expect them to be action-packed and interesting. It looks like the robots in the previous match are now being taken off the field, and they're redoing the field for the next match. Thank you, viewers, for watching this live streaming, and I hope you are liking it and are enjoying the competition from outside the school itself. Okay, so once again, for the Red Alliance, it's 7766 and 4855, and for the Blue Alliance, it's 3525 and 5938 for the for match number 16. So just recapping, in case anyone is wondering, the scoring for these matches is as follows. There is a first there are three periods. The first one is the autonomous period, where the drivers cannot control the robot with joysticks, but have to pre-program instructions for the robot to. In this case, there are IR beacons below one specific basket, and if they dispense a block on that basket, they will receive 50 points. The robot has to use sensors in order to detect this IR beaker. Well, other robots can also park on the ramp in the middle of the field for 20 points. If a robot places an autonomous block in a non-autonomous basket, they will receive 20 points. And if they place the autonomous block in the low scoring field, they score 10 points. Now in the next phase, the teleop phase, they can score blocks into baskets with 3 points in the outer baskets and 2 points in the inner. They manage to balance the balance beam in the middle, then they will get a 1.5 bonus to block score. In the end game, you can score the flag into different positions, with the highest being 35 points, and also hang in the middle hang-up pull-up bar, which is awarded 50 points. So far, we've seen aspects of all elements. We've seen autonomous, we've seen hanging, we've seen flag, block score. Everything seems to be present in this competition. We're almost ready for the autonomous period of match number 16. Blue Screws and the Dead Ringers versus Batteries in Black and Team 7766. More matches until the competition ends. Maybe around 15 more minutes and like the autonomous phase is about to happen. Like the beacon will be placed on the in the number one position. Randomly determined by a dice being thrown right before the match. Like 35-25 quickly goes for the parking, all three teams. And team 48-55 does not score the autonomous block. In some reason, is crashing into the they're barely not tipping over. So that means that two of the teams in the Blue Alliance have parking, and one of the teams in the Red Alliance has parking, with a total of 40-30 in autonomous, with Blue Alliance leading. Like, it's very close, and anything could happen at this point. Like, 48-55, it's some wheels off the ground as it ran into the center balance. That is, our referees are positioning it off the balance beam so that it can compete in box scoring phase. Now the drivers are allowed to use controllers, joysticks, to control the robot in this 2 minute period. It's us, Hotwire, and then a Poofa. Okay, it looks like team 35-25 is picking up blocks as well as 48-55. They're all concentrated on one side of the field with many playing defense. Looks like 35-25 Dead Ringers has blocks and team 59-38 is blocking. Oh, it looks like the team 35-25 just scored blocks into the outer goal. And team 48-55 has dropped some blocks. Team 48-55 just scored two blocks. Seems like the Blue Alliance has a slight lead over the Red Alliance. The 35-25 has already picked up four blocks. Team 48-55 is still picking up some blocks. It looks like team 7766 just scored 1 point in the low scoring goal. And team 35-25 scored four blocks in the balance. Looks like the game is tipping towards the Blue Alliance in this case, but seems like endgame could mean anything. Blue Alliance scores another two blocks, and the Red Alliance is slowly scoring some blocks. The end game, and it looks like team 48-55 is going for the flag. Will this score give them enough points in order to win the match? It'll be a very close match. Oh, they have 7 seconds. They might not. Looks like the Blue Alliance won this match. With the Red Alliance scoring an autonomous block in the low scoring goal, and a couple blocks the balance, but with the Blue Alliance with parking and many blocks in the balance.
All right, that last round was a very close one. Team 4855 almost getting the flag raised up, and their autonomous just barely missing. But Team 35-25 and their alliance partner had great teamwork, being able to score and defend against Team 4855's scoring mechanisms. So with that teamwork, it looks like they have beaten the Red Alliance, but great work by both teams overall. Alright, so the blocks are being reset into what appears to be groups of four on the left side. And robots are going to be taken off the field for the next match. Alright, next match will be the 17th match of the day with team 4508 and 6556 for the Red Alliance, and team 4145 and 6493 on the Blue Alliance. This should be a good match between the two teams. Very well balanced teams. Good scoring, good defense. Let's see how they do. Alright, so team 4855 will actually be replacing one of the missing teams for the Blue Alliance, by the looks of it. And the other robots will be on the field momentarily. Alright, so team 4508 will be playing on the red side, and by the looks of it, they will be trying to do a drive-by autonomous. We'll try to get a better view of that drive-by autonomous. And it also seems that team 4508 will be paired up with team 6559. 6559 has some good defense and has some efficient scoring, as well as the ability to raise the flag. Team 4855 will be teamed up with team 6493 for this current match. Team 4855 once again is replacing a missing team that was not present today. So they will be assisting team 6493 as their Blue Alliance partner. And this is once again the 17th match of today. And this will be beginning very shortly. The referees are currently making sure that the platform is lined up properly. The robots are getting in position. Alright, so this match should begin momentarily. The referees are making sure that everything is still in the correct position. Alright, so the referees are making last minute checks. So this should be almost ready for this next round. Alright, so the autonomous has gone for both teams. Team 6493 has overrun the platform. Team 6559 has landed on the platform. And it appears that E equals MC Squirrel team 4508 almost got their autonomous block in the right position, but just slightly missed. Now, team 4855 did not attempt their autonomous, so by the looks of it, the red team is slightly ahead, and I think that team 6559's robot is completely on the platform. Alright, so teleop is going to begin soon. By the looks of it, there may be some connection error with Team 4855's robot. Alright, so it seems that there are some technical difficulties regarding Team 4855's robot. This match should be beginning momentarily. Alright, it seems that there's no solution to Team 4855's robot's breakdown. Alright, so it seems that we'll just have to play possibly without 4855's robot. Alright, so Teleop will be beginning. Hopefully connection regains. Alright, so Teleop has begun. With Team 4508 trying to score their autonomous block, Team 6559 trying to get a little more blocks on that right side. Team 6493 is trying to collect as many blocks as possible. By the looks of their design, they will be trying to score it under the blue pendulum. Now Team 6559 is still trying to collect some more blocks, while 5508 seems to be still trying to collect some blocks. 6559 seems to have some trouble trying to collect those final blocks on those right block area, but seems to have two blocks and are now trying to score them. And one has been lodged inside their robot, but they have still one more to try to score, and they might be able to score that one. Team 4855 has still not connected, and 6559 is still trying to drive around and collect one block. 4508 seems to not be moving, may have lost connection, but 6493 for the Blue Alliance is still attempting to collect blocks on the left side. Now team 6559 is trying to prepare for hanging for the end game. Let's see if they can do it. Oh no, they're having trouble getting on the ramp. Team 6493 is trying to get some more blocks under their pendulum. And team 4508 on the bottom left side for the red line still does not seem to be moving. So, nice try by both teams. Great job by both of them. There was great teamwork by the red team. Great autonomous. And some nice playing by the blue team as well. Alright, so next for our final match will be our 18th match of today. Currently, blocks are being reset on the field. Alright, so blocks are still being removed, and the robots are getting prepared for the next match. That this match will be team 5939 allied with team 5604. Team 5604 has a very efficient block collecting system, and 5939 has a very reliable autonomous as well as the ability to collect many blocks. This should allow for a very close game. Team 7013 on the Blue Alliance also has a very efficient autonomous as well as block scoring ability. Their alliance partner also has good defense, so this should allow for a very competitive game. Alright, so the robots are being prepared. There seems to be some communication on the red side for the red alliance to see what position they would like to take up for this autonomous run. We'll give you a nicer view of the autonomous. Alright, let's see if team 5939 can successfully complete their autonomous. This will be a very close game. So let's see who can come up on top. Alright, so this round is about to start. Some final adjustments will be made with the robots, their positions, as well as the competitors' locations. 7465 for the blue team seems to be positioned directly at the leftmost bucket for the balancing area. to allow them for some easy block collection and possibly scoring of that first block. Alright, so this round is about to start with Autonomous. Let's go. Team 5939-0 has ran into the block area and has not successfully scored their Autonomous. Team 5604, however, has successfully parked on the ramp. But Team 7013 has now contested their ramp location, but both are on the ramp. Team 5939 is still stuck on the balance beam, but will be okay. Team 7465, part of the Blue Alliance, has not moved, but may score blocks during teleop. Alright, we will now give you a better view of the entire field. Some final checks are being made, and teleop should be beginning soon. Alright, so Team 5604 will be collecting blocks on the left side, trying to get as many blocks as possible, and trying to score blocks as quickly as possible. Team 7013 is contesting Team 5939's collection on the right side. Team 5604 has just scored three blocks on the leftmost area. Team 5939, however, is losing their blocks on the right side. Team 5604 has collected four more blocks and is about to score them on the leftmost bucket area. Team 5939 is having trouble with their blocks and has successfully scored one block on the rightmost block collection area, but is having trouble with their second block. Team 5604 is still going for more blocks and once again has, I believe, two more blocks in their collection area. They're going for the balance on the right side, though they have three blocks and are going for the balance and will be able to score almost all three blocks. They're having trouble with their controls, trying to get that third. Oh, they have dropped one of their blocks. Team 7013, however, have stacked their blue pendulum on the right side with as many blocks as possible. I do not believe that they are trying for balance, but instead as many blocks as they can shove into that bucket. Team 5604, once again, are going for the balance on the right side of the pendulum. They have three blocks, I believe, and now that is the end game symbol. They're going... Team 5604 is going for the flag, and now they have gotten their, and Team 5939 have gotten their hanging, as well as 7013, but Blue Team has also gotten flag, so by the looks of it, this is a extremely close game. Oh, nicely done by the red team to score that final block under the pendulum. Oh, this has been a very close game. Nicely done by both teams. All right, thank you guys for being here. This is the end of the Washington League tournament.